Have you ever opened a massive codebase and felt completely overwhelmed, wondering where to even begin? It's a feeling that hits every developer, whether you were a junior on your first day or a senior joining a new team. And in today's video, I'm going to share proven strategies that will transform how you approach understanding large codebases. The biggest mistake many developers make when approaching a massive codebase is thinking they have to understand everything all at once.
Yes, it is a mistake.
This is exhausting and ineffective. So, what's the secret senior developers use? Well, there is no such thing as a secret, but they focus on understanding one function at a time, breaking down the complexity into digestible pieces. That's what you should do. Start with just one function. Understand what it does, what it returns, what it depends on, then move on to the next function. Now, this begs the question, if you are inside a large code base with thousands of methods, how do you even choose where to begin or where to start? Simple. Follow a single flow, no branching. Pick a page, a route, an API call, something that interests you, or something that you are working on. If you're a front-end developer, start by identifying the entry point for a specific feature you want to understand. Whether that's through your routes.ts file or a file-based routing system. And if you're a back-end developer, start where the API begins, typically in your controllers. This targeted approach immediately gives you context and direction. But here's where most people get sidetracked. They start jumping around the whole codebase randomly. Please, don't do that. Stick to the flow. Don't get distracted by what other files are doing. Stay focused. Treat the surrounding noise like black boxes. If the function you are calling returns what you expect, it's okay not to care, for now. How is doing that? The key insight here is that breaking everything down into manageable parts prevents the mental fatigue that comes from trying to grasp complex systems all at once. It's like the difference between eating a whole pizza in one bite versus enjoying it slice by slice. Some projects have good docs, some don't, but if they exist, please read them. And if you are lucky enough to work with developers who've been on a project longer than you, talk to them. Ask good questions, take notes, and whatever you do, never ask the same question twice, especially when you are talking to senior engineers. Respect their time, document what they say, and speaking of documentation, make your own. Every insight, every connection, every behavior you understand, write it down. You are not just doing your future self a favor. You are preparing to be the person other devs ask for help. Reading code is not just for juniors. It's a skill that even senior engineers constantly use and refine. After you've gone through the flow you want to understand and perhaps talked with colleagues, it's time to get your hands dirty. The simplest way to see what's happening is to run the code, but with a twist. Pepper the flow you are investigating with extra log statements to see the data and the execution path in real time. For a more powerful and surgical approach, you need to master your debugger. I know it has a steep learning curve, but try setting breakpoints at the start of your choosing function or flow. And then, meticulously step through the code, line by line, watching how variables change and how the logic branches. This is single-handedly one of the most effective ways to truly understand what's happening. Once you think you understand how something works, test that by making small safe changes and watching what happens. Does it break? Does it behave as you expected? If your intuition is right, then you are on the right path. Now, what about AI assistants like ChatGPT, Claude, or Gemini? It is tempting to just paste a giant file and ask, what does this do? But that's a recipe for failure. Why? The AI will hallucinate about imports and functions that it can see. The smart way to use AI is to feed it small specific parts, like a single method. And if that method calls another helper function, you must provide the code for that helper function as well as the full context of the code, so that the AI will get to know the full context. So, the next time that you are faced with an intimidating code base, just remember the plan. Start with a single entry point and follow one flow. Use your debugger and logs. Talk to your teammates and document what you learn. And most importantly, be patient. Mastering this is a skill that will serve you for your entire career. So guys, if you found these strategies helpful and want to level up your software engineering skills with more practical tips like these, make sure to subscribe to the channel. I post practical no-fluff videos like this 2 times in a week. So hit that subscribe button and start leveling up. See you again next time.